What a girl, what a world, what a life. Oh, I married Joan. What a mind, love is blind, what a wife. He is gay all day, she keeps my heart laughing. Heaven aware, her brain is blown. To each his own. Can he not ask why I married Joan?
The Joan Davis Show. I Married Joan, America's favorite comedy show, starring America's queen of comedy, Joan Davis, as Mrs. Joan Stevens. And featuring Jim Backus as Judge Bradley Stevens.
Frozen soup, frozen chicken, frozen potatoes, frozen pie. Ah, there's nothing like a home-cooked meal. I must stay home one of these days and cook one. See, I wonder if I've forgotten anything. I don't know why, but I've been forgetting an awful lot these days. Fly away, Birdie. Here, come on. Oh, you hurt its little leg. Well, now you wait right there, and Joni will fix it for you. You wait right there. Right there. Here, Joni will fix your leg now. Come on, this won't hurt a bit, and it'll just help it while it heals. That's a good boy. Now you wait right there, and I'm going to get a box and make you a bed, you nice little crow. You know something? You look tired. You've got people's feet under your eyes. You've got a cold, too, huh? Here, I've got something for you. Here. Now you munch on that. Isn't that good? I'm going to make a nice bed for you. Now you stay right there. Will you?
Hello, darling.
Oh, Brad, I wish your head was bigger.
You wish my head was bigger? John, what are you talking about?
This hat box of yours, dear. I'm just hoping it won't be too small for Christopher.
Christopher who?
Oh, I don't know his last name. I just named him Christopher. Oh, it's the darlingest crow. He hurt his leg, so he flew in the kitchen window and I fixed it.
What was wrong with the kitchen window?
I didn't fix the kitchen window. I fixed Christopher's leg. That's why I'm making him this bed to convalesce in. He's gone.
Well, he must have flown back out the window.
But he's in no condition to fly. He should be grounded.
Look, dear, I have to look over some briefs before dinner. Oh, Joan, did you get the bank statements like I asked you?
I forgot.
Well, that's all right, dear. You remember tomorrow, Okay.
I think I forgot. Oh, Brad, you doll boy. He's the same mad, impetuous, romantic spendthrift I married. Brad, I love you!
Oh,
Why, each one is a pearl.
Tell me, Brad. Are they imitation or artificial?
What are you talking about?
Oh, you know very well. What a wonderful surprise, hiding them in my purse.
Look, dear, I'm in no mood for jokes. I had a very tough day in court. I had a case I couldn't settle in court today.
Well, I'm sorry, dear. Do you want to tell me about it?
Well, it was Gluefinger Sebastian. I had him right there before me and couldn't convict him. Well, now he's free again.
Why didn't you just send him to jail?
Well, Joni, he always has an airtight alibi. He's always miles away from where the robberies occur. I know he has an accomplice, but the police can't find him.
And with all your problems, you still thought about surprising me with the pearls.
Joni, will you please?
Oh, honey, will you answer that, dear? I want to see how they look on.
Hello, Judge.
Hello, Janet. Look, if it's the 15 cents you're looking for, I found it and smoked it after dinner last night.
It must be here. I was wearing them while I was talking to Joni this afternoon. I've been meaning to have the clasp fixed. It's weak.
Wait a minute. A light is beginning to dawn. It couldn't by any chance happen to be a pearl necklace you're looking for.
Well, of course it's my pearl necklace. What else? Did you find it?
It's going to be tough to pry loose. Oh, Joni, the mystery of the pearl necklace is solved. Oh, excuse me, it's the back door, Janet.
Where did Joan find my pearls?
In her purse. She thought that I put them there.
In her purse? Well, how did they get there?
Well, don't ask me. You women never know where you put things.
Oh, hello, Janet. Aren't they beautiful?
They're very becoming. Now, may I have them, please? Kerwin and I are going out to dinner.
Can you have them?
I just got them. Oh, please, Joni, I'm in a hurry.
Well, I don't think I should lend them the first night that I get them.
Lend them? Those happen to be my cultured pearls.
Your pearls? I can see you haven't been wearing your pith helmet under the noonday sun. Dogs in the...
If you will look on the clasp, you'll see it's my necklace. I dropped them here this afternoon.
Then how did they get into my purse?
Well, that's a question I'd like cleared up, too.
Brad put them there to surprise me.
Well, Brad says otherwise.
Then what were you doing in my purse?
What was I... I wasn't near your purse.
Well, they certainly didn't crawl in there to get more culture.
Don't... You mean you don't remember finding them and hiding them in your bag?
It was the milkman. Well, have you girls got the pearl necklace situation all cleared up?
Brad, she says that you didn't put these in my bag to surprise me, that they're hers.
Joni, I told you before I didn't put them there. Now, will you be a good girl and give them to Janet?
I'll be more careful. In the future.
Well, stop giving me that fishy look. You'd think I was trying to steal your own pearls.
Now, look, Joni, no one is accusing you of anything as silly as that. Well, now, look.
Well, with some people, it's like a sickness.
Sickness? There's your old pearls.
Sickness? Janet, what are you talking about?
Judge, may I see you for a moment privately?
Have you had any hallucinations before or found strange things in your purse?
The only strange thing I ever found in my purse was money. You think I am a kleptomaniac?
Oh, that's Kerwin in the car. I've got to run. Oh, Joni, in the meantime, if you have any shopping to do, I would advise you to do it by mail.
Why, I...
Joni, stop the nonsense and we'll have a nice evening and go out for dinner.
Oh, Brad, you don't think I'm a mental case, do you?
Of course not. There's nothing mental about you.
You're sweet. Honey, I'll go and change for dinner. Oh, what'll I wear?
Oh, anything, as long as it doesn't have pockets.
Oh, finally decided to come home, huh, Roborosa? Still pulling the old sympathy bit with the leg, huh? What was it this time? Blonde? Always falling for dames. Last year was that redhead. Took me 2 weeks to teach you to bring the loot back here again. Thank you.
I don't care for pearls. I don't even like oysters. I never really wanted the pearls. Christopher! You wouldn't hear it if it was a brass band. Christopher! It's Joni!
No. Must have been that beef a la mode I ate. Last time I'll put ice cream on my beef. If I don't get some sleep, I'll have 4 new crow's feet in the morning. Crow's feet. Now, why did I say that? Poor little Christopher flying around with a lame leg. Oh, no. I must be dreaming. Brett! Wait, how am I going to explain it to myself? Oh, I must be a kleptomaniac. I must do my klepting in my sleep.
Well, all I ask, Brad, is when I come up for trial to please remember I've been a very good wife except for second-story work nights.
Joni, there is no direct evidence that you are a kleptomaniac. You were merely on a ladder leading to an open second-story window in the middle of the night when the pajamas and robe were moved.
Now, who could be suspicious of an innocent-looking thing like that? I could have been picking roses.
On the second floor?
They could have had long stems. Brad! That's the cops. I'm not dressed. I wouldn't let them see me.
Don't you be silly, dear. No one is going to arrest you. Not while I'm here, dear. Not while the judge is here.
Now, the way to clear this up is to follow the logical chain of events. I was in this room, and I went to the dresser, opened my purse to get a handkerchief, and there was... It must have been at people's houses I don't even know. Brad?
Tell me, officer, were there any clues?
Well, I don't know anything about that, sir. My job is just to canvass the neighborhood and find out if there were more robberies that weren't reported. Did you find any jewels or anything missing this morning?
I hope so. I don't know, but however, I'll check for you. Joni, are we missing any jewelry?
No, I think I got it all.
I guess we were unfortunate enough to be missed. That is, there was nothing worthwhile in the house for the robber to be concerned with. Well, thanks again for calling, officer.
Thank you, Judge.
Yes, not at all. Joan! That was Officer Brannigan. He said there was some jewelry missing in the neighborhood last night.
Well, Brad, you don't think that I...
Now, look, dear, we all have problems to face, and to some of us, these problems we don't even suspect exist. Honey, let me explain.
Would you mind standing up and explaining it to me?
Well, why should I stand up?
Well, I'm very nervous with this problem that I'm facing. I'm sitting on pins and
Now, look. There are people, and perfectly good people, who take things belonging to other people without knowing why or what they're going to do with them.
You mean the Income Tax Bureau?
No, dear, no, no. Now, if I were to tell you that you were suffering from a mental lapse, what would you say?
Well, I'd say...
Yes?
Oh, I was excited. I'm stuck.
No, no, you're not. A very good friend of mine, Dr. Oglethorpe, happens to be one of the very best psychiatrists. I'll see him on my way to the office and have him stop by and see you this morning. And remember, he's used to treating people whose troubles are deep-seated.
Oh, I got a dilly for him.
Now, look here. He'll help you. Do whatever he says and trust him. Will you do that for me?
Brad, I'll do anything for you. Just go before I get lockjaw.
Oh, that's my girl. And remember, things like this have been cured without leaving the slightest scar.
Oh. Who said diamonds are a girl's best friend?
Here, Rubirosa. So, this is the house, huh? Well, you stay right there. I'll talk to you later.
Brad, his sweet, wonderful, adoring wife has turned out to be another Dr. Jekyll and Mrs. Hyde. What if the psychiatrist will bring his own couch with him?
Oh, hello.
Oh, please come in. I've been expecting you.
You have?
Yes. In fact, I was expecting you even sooner, Dr. Oglethorpe.
You were?
Yes. I hope you'll excuse me. I'm just a little nervous. I've never been psychoanalyzed before.
Oh? Oh. Well, there's really nothing to it.
I see. Well, pull up a chair, Doc.
Now tell me. Did anything strange happen here yesterday?
Well, I met Christopher. That's what I named him. He's a darling little crow.
Oh, that's very important. Go on.
Well, he flew in the window. And he hurt his little leg, so I fixed it, and then he flew away again. Do you think maybe that has something to do with my problem?
I think we're at the heart of the matter. And tell me, what did you do with all the things you collected?
Well, I hid them so nobody could find them. I was scared.
Well, I'd call that a normal reaction. Perfectly easy to understand. Nothing at all unusual about that. A perfectly normal reaction. And where did you hide them?
I don't know. I told you I hid them so nobody would find them.
You mean you don't remember where... Try to think. You must remember. Search your memory.
Oh, I don't know where I put that either. I'm a mixed up kid. I know I hid them somewhere in the house, but I don't know whose house.
Were you in somebody else's house today?
No, I think.
Then they must be in this house. I think. Where do you usually hide?
When?
The jewels. Where are the jewels? Find them if I have to turn this room upside down. Well, they're obviously not here.
Maybe they're in the bedroom. Let's go. And the bedroom is this way. See, maybe they're... Oh, no, that would be silly. Nobody would hide jewels in there.
Where?
In my jewel box.
That's too obvious.
That would be absolutely ridiculous.
It would be the first place anybody'd look.
Yeah, it's even got jewels printed in gold letters on the box. See that? Jewel. You know, a person would have to be absolutely crazy to hide jewels in there.
You'd have to be absolutely insane.
Screwy.
Cracked.
Nuts. Shall we take a peek? The jewels. I am crazy.
You're right. Both times.
Dr. Oglethorpe, where are you going?
Mexico. I got a very sick patient down there.
Oh, that's too bad.
All right, Sebastian. This is it.
Sebastian, that's Dr. Oglethorpe.
Well, he finally got his accomplice.
Okay, let's go on down to the station. How's both of you?
Oh, yeah.
No. No!
No. Get out your rubber hoses. Pull out my fingernails. That's all I'm going to say.
Now, look, lady, we don't buy that kleptomania story. Why don't you just admit you're an 809?
I am not.
Joni!
Brad!
Judge Stevens!
Joni, what have they done to you?
Please, Brad, I'm not dry yet. I don't know what he's saying. You see, honey?
Judge, you mean you know this crook? This crook happens to be my wife.
Oh, Brad, I didn't want them to discover that. You're married to an 809.
No, don't you cry, dear. Everything is going to be all right. But, Judge, we didn't know.
Yeah, we're working on this case and we caught this crook. I mean, your wife with the missing jewels.
What else could we think? My wife happens to be a very sick woman.
In the head. Oh, Brad, why don't you just leave me? Go away. Leave me. Make a life of your own. There's plenty of chicken liver in the freezer. I darned your brown wool socks. Brought back your overdue library book. Make a fresh start. Oh, I saved the soup bones for you. He loves to pick on the bones. The marrow's good for him. Makes him nice and...
Not now, now, Johnny. No one is going to leave you. We're going to straighten this whole thing out. But we already booked her, Your Honor. How are we going to explain it?
My wife is a victim of circumstantial evidence.
You mean I'm not an 809?
Oh, you're not even a 2x4. Joan, I've been doing a lot of thinking about this, and you just couldn't have committed these robberies.
How'd you discover it?
Well, I don't know. I haven't figured it out yet, but there's a missing link somewhere.
Christopher, you've come back to me.
You mean that's your bird? Joni. Joni, look. What do you know?
I never would have believed it.
There's your burglar.
Christopher, it was you who was walking in my sleep.
No wonder most of the robberies we investigated lately had some little black feathers left at the scene. Take that crow into custody and book him as an accomplice and accessory.
Okay, Lieutenant. What do you know? And all the time we thought we were up against a mastermind.
All the time, it was only a bird brain. Oh, not you, Christopher. Me. Well, I still think that was an awfully harsh verdict you gave Christopher. Couldn't you have shown a little more leniency?
Joni, we've been through this 100 times. If you want, it's within your constitutional rights to take it to a higher court.
My little Christopher, a jailbird. A kid.
That's why I married Joan.